Virgin Galactic's next flight. New update on Starship launch. SpaceX's new target for Falcon series.
Hello everyone, welcome back. Here is our new episode with latest SpaceX and space news. So, let's get started.
Let's discuss some exciting news from Virgin Galactic, and it looks like they're closing out this year with a mission set for early November. Virgin Galactic recently announced that their next flight, known as Galactic 05, is scheduled for a window that opens on November 2nd. This mission will take place at Spaceport America in New Mexico. What's unique about this mission is that it's the fifth commercial flight for Virgin Galactic and the sixth flight for their VSS Unity suborbital spaceplane, all within just a few months since late May. Now, what makes Galactic 05 particularly interesting is that it's described as a research flight by the company. This means it's not just about space tourism, they're taking researchers on board. Among the crew, there are two notable researchers, Alan Stern and Kelly Girardi. Alongside them, there's a third customer described as a Franco-Italian private astronaut. Virgin Galactic has been emphasizing the importance of suborbital research as an alternative use of their vehicles compared to pure space tourism. They believe it could be more lucrative on a perceived basis. Michael Koldlazier, the CEO of Virgin Galactic, said, "We're thrilled to offer a wide breadth of high-quality and reliable access to space-based research. Insights from this flight will be used to enhance and refine the research capabilities of our future Delta fleet." The mission will be led by Mike Masucci as the commander, with Kelly Latimer serving as the pilot and Colin Bennett as the in-flight astronaut instructor. It's worth noting that Galactic 05 is the last mission to have an astronaut instructor on board. Starting with Galactic 06 and all subsequent flights, they'll carry four private astronaut customers. Koldlazier mentioned in an earnings call that they might replace the astronaut instructor with a fourth customer as they move into 2024. As a conclusion, Virgin Galactic is gearing up for Galactic 05, a research-focused suborbital mission set for early November. It's the last mission of the year, with Galactic 06 planned for January to allow for routine vehicle inspections. The company is not only advancing space tourism, but also exploring the exciting world of suborbital research. Well, it looks like there's a chance we might see another Starship orbital flight very soon. Yes, you heard it right. First things first, there's a notice that's got us buzzing with anticipation. According to Mariner Hazard Warnings, SpaceX is aiming to launch Starship from their Starbase facility in Boca Chica, Texas. You might remember that this facility is right near the beautiful beaches of South Padre Island. The target date for this launch is November 1, 2023, and they're planning to launch between 5:25 a.m. and 11:15 a.m. But wait, there's more! If the conditions are right, they've set up backup launch dates and times for every day after November 1st, still within the same time frame. Mariners who are out at sea near Brownsville, Texas, have been advised about these launch activities as they can impact navigation. There's the possibility of falling debris or rocket components coming down, so safety first, folks. Now, this notice isn't a guarantee that the launch will happen on November 1st, but it's a clear sign of SpaceX's determination to make another Starship launch happen this year. They've been dealing with some regulatory challenges, but they're not giving up. Speaking of not giving up, the SpaceX team is at it again with their relentless efforts. Just recently, they tested another Starship prototype, known as Ship 26. In this test, it looked like the Starship had a kind of depressed vent, and then, something really cool happened. It had a little burst of fire, kind of like a single engine test. So, what's the big deal with this small test, you ask? Well, it all has to do with the Raptor engine. The Raptor engine is one of the most complex rocket engines ever developed. It uses something called a full-flow staged combustion cycle, or FFSC for short. This is a fancy way of saying that it goes through many, many steps to turn liquid propellants into thrust. Here's the challenge: Raptor engines use cryogenic liquid methane and oxygen, which means they're extremely cold. But to work, they need to be turned into super hot gas pretty much instantly. That's where pre-burners come into play. In a full-flow staged combustion engine like the Raptor, both the oxidizer, that's the oxygen, and the fuel, the methane, need their own separate turbo pumps. These pumps need pre-burners to create the pressure required to power those turbo pumps. Now, these pre-burners are put under a lot of stress because they need to produce gas at very high pressures. Why? Well, as the gases make their way through all the twists and turns of the engine's plumbing, some energy is lost. To make up for those losses and achieve high combustion chamber pressure, like Raptor's 300 plus bar or over 4,400 psi, the pre-burners need to produce gas at even higher pressures. As a result, pre-burners are one of the most stressed systems in an engine like the Raptor. This is why SpaceX often tests these pre-burners separately before they go for the full engine ignition test. It's like a way of making sure everything is working smoothly before they light up the whole engine. So, there you have it, folks. I think SpaceX is determined to make another Starship launch happen this year, and they're working tirelessly on perfecting the complex Raptor engine, one step at a time. It's all part of their mission to make space travel more accessible and exciting. If we were to consider a situation where SpaceX didn't exist, one can't help but wonder how long it might have taken NASA to create a spacecraft similar to SpaceX's Starship Super Heavy. Think about it. Do you know, SpaceX is taking its launch cadence to unprecedented heights? In 2023, they've already set a record by launching 74 orbital missions, more than any other private space company in a single year. And here's the kicker, they're not done yet. In the next 2.5 months, they're planning even more spaceflight action. During a hearing of the U.S. Senate Subcommittee on Space and Science on October 18th, Bill Gerstenmayer, SpaceX's Vice President of Build and Flight Reliability, made a jaw-dropping announcement. He said, "This year, we're going to attempt to fly 100 flights. Yes, you heard that right, 100 flights in a single year. But that's not all. SpaceX isn't content with just 100 flights. They're already setting their sights on the future." Gerstenmayer added, "As we look to next year, we want to increase that flight rate to about 12 flights per month, or 144 flights. That's 144 missions in 1 year. It's a breathtaking goal that pushes the boundaries of what's possible in spaceflight. To hit the century mark this year, SpaceX will need to significantly increase their launch cadence from one mission every 3.9 days to one every 2.8 days. It might sound ambitious, but SpaceX has shown they're up to the task. They've launched two missions in a single day multiple times, demonstrating their incredible efficiency. In March, for example, they sent two Falcon 9 rockets into the sky less than 4.5 hours apart. SpaceX isn't lacking in payloads either. They're actively expanding their Starlink internet satellite mega constellation, which currently includes around 5,000 operational satellites. But here's the kicker, they have permission to deploy a whopping 12,000 Starlink satellites, and they've applied for approval to launch an additional 30,000 spacecraft on top of that. That's a game changer for global internet connectivity. In fact, about 60% of SpaceX's launches in 2023 have been dedicated to Starlink missions. This shows their commitment to bringing high-speed internet to even the most remote corners of the world.
So that's all about today's episode. See you tomorrow, and until then, goodbye.